The shock troops of Cadia have endured decades of rigorous firing drills, forging them into expert sharpshooters. In this video, we're going to be showing you how to paint a Cadian shock trooper sergeant to a battle-ready standard. Now, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model, and to do this, we've chosen to use Zandri Dust. Then we'll start with the first stages, using Vulcan Green for the flak armour, Corax White for the chevrons, and then shading both of those with Norn Oil. So let's get some Vulcan Green here onto the palette. A little bit more. Thin it down with a touch of water just to make a nice smooth consistency. Then roll your brush up to a nice point. Then we're just going to pick out all of those areas of flak armour. Now this is a layer paint, but it's the perfect colour for the armour. So you might just want to do a couple of coats of this. With all the green areas, including the cap, picked out, we're now going to use Corax White just to pick out those chevrons. Now we're going to shade all over the green and the white with Norn Oil. If you find that it starts pooling in the recesses, just clean off your brush and use it to soak up the excess. With the flak armour done, we're now going to move on to the fatigues. And for these, we're just going to get some Agrax Earthshade and thin it down with some Larmium Medium. So we're going to take one part Larmium Medium onto the palette here, quite a big dollop there. Clean off the brush and dry it off. And then one part Agrax Earthshade and mix that together there. Yep, then make sure not to overload your brush, and then we're going to apply that all over those areas that are Zandri Dust. And with that shade done, we're now going to move on to some other areas. So for the black details, we're going to use Abaddon Black. Then for the brown leather, we're going to base coat with Rhinox Hide and shade with Agrax Earthshade. So let's get some Abaddon Black here onto the palette. A little bit more. We definitely want to thin this down as it is quite thick. Then as always, make sure you've got a nice point on your brush. And we're just going to pick out all of those black details. This is things like the chainsword and the boots, as well as the gun casing. If you're ever not sure which areas to pick out, just refer back to the box art. Now the black's done, we're going to use Rhinox Hide to paint in all the brown leather details. Take your time with this and be as neat as you can, especially around those areas that we've already painted. But don't worry, if you do make any mistakes, you can always just tidy back up with the previous colours. Now that all the brown details are picked out, we're going to shade them with Agrax Earthshade. We're taking it straight from the pot this time. With the brown done, we're now going to move on to the metallics. For these, we're going to base coat with Iron Hand Steel and then shade with Norn Oil. So let's get some Iron Hand Steel here onto the palette. Quite a bit, and then thin it down just to make it a little bit smoother. There we go. Then we're just going to pick out all of those metallic details. The next thing to do is to shade all the metallics. For this, we're just going to use Norn Oil. I'm going to apply this quite heavily to get some more depth in the recesses. With that stage finished, we're now going to move on to the skin. For this, we're going to use Cadian Flesh Tone, then we're going to apply Gilliman Flesh, thinned down with Contrast Medium over the top. So let's get some Cadian Flesh Tone here onto the palette. We want to make sure this is quite thin, so we're going to add quite a bit of water to it. A little bit more. There we go. Then we're just going to pick out all of the skin on the model. So that's the face and also the hands. You probably need to do a few thin layers of this. With the skin base coated, we're now going to apply Gillam and Flesh over the top, and we thin this down with one part contrast medium. And now our miniature's finished, we can move on to the base. So for this, we're going to apply Sterling Battlemire all over the base, then shade it with Agrax Earthshade. So I've got my Citadel texture tool here, and using the large end, we're going to just scoop some out of the tub. Then we're just going to carefully apply that onto the base of the miniature, making sure we avoid the feet. When it gets to those fiddly bits, we're going to use the smaller end of the tool to help us be nice and neat. After leaving the technical paint to dry for around an hour, we're now going to apply Agrax Earthshade all over the top. This will just help to create some depth in the recesses of the technical paint. And with the base finished, the last thing to do is to paint the rim in a colour that matches the rest of your army. In this case, we've used Steel Legion Drab. Now our sergeant is finished, complete with transfers, ready to lead troops in dogged offence and storming assaults against any who threaten the Imperium. So there's just a couple of things to remember when you're painting this miniature. When base coating, try and be as neat as you can, as this will provide a better end result. But don't worry, if you do make any mistakes, you can always just tidy back up with the previous colours. Also, when you're using shades and contrast, be careful not to overload your brush, as these can quickly run out of control on the miniature. However, if you find this happening, just clean off your brush and use it to soak up the excess. Well, that's the end of the video. We hope you've enjoyed watching, and we hope you have great fun painting your own miniatures. We'll see you in the next one. Bye!